I got some questions about my workflow shooting ProRes RAW. And how I convert it to Cinema DNG to grade it in DaVinci Resolve. I just want to say that I'm by no means a pro colorist or expert in DaVinci Resolve. This is just based on information I found here on YouTube and tweaked to my own workflow, so have that in mind. All right, I shot this clip with my Zcam S6 using the Ninja V. And for inspiration, I had this frame from Interstellar with Matthew standing in front of a window. And I have a window in my office, so I thought I might be able to pull this off, kind of. First off, we have to convert this ProRes RAW clip to Cinema DNG. And there's several ways to do it. But I use this software called RAW Converter. And it looks like this. And it's very easy to use. It lets you choose between 5 different compressions. I tend to use the 5:1 compression because, in my opinion, it's a perfect balance between quality and file size. You just browse to your clip, which is on my hard drive from the Ninja V, which is very convenient because I don't have to offload the footage to my computer first and then convert it. I just convert it straight from the Ninja V hard drive. Here we have the clip. And you set an output folder here. I choose the compression 5:1 and click convert. Yes, now the converter is done. So let's open up a DaVinci Resolve project. Drag and drop the converted file into the media bin. Now it looks kind of weird, blown out, but we're gonna do some changes in the project settings. Let's go to the camera raw tab. Here we're gonna change the raw profile from ARRI to Cinema DNG. We're gonna change the code using project and color space. We're gonna go for Blackmagic Design and Blackmagic Design Film. You also can tick this highlight recovery box and hit save. And as you can see, the clip is now looking more like it should. No blown out highlights because we told DaVinci Resolve how to interpret the footage. From there, we're gonna create a new timeline. And also we're gonna import the our inspiration for this, which is Matthew. Let's find a good sequence here. Look at this acting, it's amazing. All right, and just pull it down to the timeline. Once we have a clip in the timeline, we want to convert it from Blackmagic to DaVinci Wide Gamut because we want to do all the adjustments in a larger color space container. So let's start by doing a color transform sandwich. So I'm gonna create 1, 2, 3 nodes. And I'm gonna start with a color space transform. And as input color space, we're gonna choose Black Magic Gen 4.5. And input gamma is Black Magic Film. Output color space, we're gonna choose DaVinci Wide Gamut and DaVinci Intermediate. And on this last node, I'm gonna put another color space transform. And we want to go from DaVinci Wide Gamut to Rec. 709. So I choose DaVinci Wide Gamut, DaVinci Intermediate, output color space, Rec. 709, and gamma 2.4. Now we are in Rec. 709 with this clip. I often use the Kodak 2383 LUT, which comes free with the DaVinci Resolve. It's a very common film print emulation that converts Cinion film log to Rec. 709. So to use it, we have to change our output on our last CST to Cinian Film Log. And on this last node, we go to LUT, and we go to Film Looks, and we go down to the Rec 709 Kodak 2383D65. And now we have a good starting point to start to work with the adjustments. This is one way to use the Kodak print emulation, but now we're outside the DaVinci wide gamut, and that can be impractical for several reasons. I saw this video from a YouTuber. His name is Jake Pierre Lee. I leave a link to his channel in the description. He talks about these different workflows, and he actually made a custom-made Kodak 2383 LUT that works within the DaVinci wide gamut color space, and he gives them away for free. So head over to his channel and download it after you watch this. That's what I'm gonna use here on the node before our last CST instead of this workflow. So I'm gonna delete this node and change it back to Gamma 2.4. And I'm gonna load this LUT instead, 2383 Inter, DaVinci Wide Gamut, 2383 D65. We're now finished with the base of the node tree. Let's go to the RAW tab. Here you can see that everything is grayed out right now, but you have to switch the decode using project to clip instead, and everything is now available. Not ISO, but we have this exposure adjustment, which works in a similar way. I like to do all the initial adjustments in the RAW tab, like exposure, white balance, tint, and saturation. And after that, I continue doing adjustments in the node tree. So let's check out our reference and start tweaking the image. I'm gonna start with the exposure and bring it down to something like this. And also, the reference is way cooler in many ways. Let's cool it down like this. From now, I can just start adding nodes in between these two CSTs so that I work in the DaVinci wide gamut. If we zoom into the reference, there is a lot of grain because this was shot on film, of course. So I can add a node here in between the CSTs, and I'm gonna add some grain. And I'm gonna go for 35 millimeter, 400T. I'm gonna start tweaking the aspect ratio. I think it was shot in anamorphic. So let's see what happens if I tweak this. Yeah, looks kind of right. And there's a lot of saturation in the grain in the reference. So let's add some saturation. And maybe some softness to it. Yeah, perfect. Let's check it out. Yes, there you have it. My workflow, shooting ProRes RAW, converting it to Cinema DNG, and grading it in DaVinci Resolve. Thanks for watching.